How's she going, my son, and welcome back to Undertale. The game has been patched, I mentioned it previously, and content has been added, as I suspected. Now, I don't know how much of it I can access from where I am at the true pacifist ending type sequence, but, actually, I'm gonna turn down my audio, because I'm sure in the recording I can be heard, but I can't even hear myself, and I think it's part of the reason why I'm talking too loudly and peaking the audio in some previous videos. Apologies for that. I gotta get used to this whole microphone business. Okay, there we go. Not as blaring in my ears, so I don't have to feel like I have to talk over it when obviously I don't, because I have it all set up in OBS to make it work otherwise. So, I don't know how much of the new content I can access in the True Pacifist post battle ending type sequence, so we're gonna keep getting the Toriel texts. Toriel sent you a message. Forward, send this to someone you care about, or a skeleton will rattle his bones at you. Oh crap. Dear Frisk, thought you might enjoy this. Smiley face. Esky art of a snail. But yeah, we'll get the tutorial texts, we'll chat up some NPCs. I heard there's something new with Burger Pants, or as I like to call him, Ren, because I always think he's Ren from Ren and Stimpy, because of all the crazy expressions he makes. Damn it, cursor. And, you know, something about that, and, something in the Sand's secret room. The room that we discovered in this playthrough. So hopefully we get to see something in there. Dear Frisk, Undyne and Papyrus want to cook something together with me. Sand is telling me that they are excellent chefs. I am excited. Maybe if you are lucky, you can have some. Dear Frisk, if Sans and I started a band, do you know what we would call it? Dreamer and Femur. Oh! P.S. That is only a joke. Do not refer to me as Dreamer. Aw. Aw, oh, poor Tori. Poor Asgore. Dear Frisk, Undyne is very strong. Papyrus made a bet with her that she could not lift everyone here up. She could. The only trouble is that she doesn't know how to put everyone down. Oh, that's amazing. Dear Frisk, Alphys is telling me many interesting facts about the human world. Quite a few of them are wrong, though. Frisk, you did not tell her anything funny, did you? Goat smiley. Dear Frisk, I heard that using the computer for too long is bad for you. However, I have not seen you use the computer at all. You must be very healthy. How nice. Dear Frisk, I think I may have to turn off the phone for now. Your friends are all very lovely people. I think I will spend this time getting to know them better. Be good, alright? Sincerely, Toriel. Aw, I think I might have actually run them out. Aw, we might have run them out. Shoot. Oh well. Now, something I missed, because this is a pacifist playthrough, is that if you double back through an area, there's NPCs roaming about that are presumably the encounter monsters that aren't going to fight you anymore. Yeah, like this guy here. Why do I look like a black sausage and not a knight or a wizard? Well, everyone has an angle they look best from. I suppose that's true. Why do I look like a black sausage? Not a knight or a wizard. That's hilarious. I might cut some of the walking. I don't know. I'm in no particular hurry. Gotta love this total Earthbound sequence, though. You know, you get to backtrack through the game world you've saved. Admittedly, one of the best parts of that is you get to use the bicycle again. Because for the longest time in Earthbound, you can use a bicycle, but then the second you get a second party member, or you try to carry a teddy bear around, you can't use a bicycle anymore. Core is made up of interchangeable rooms. Before you came here, the layout was altered so you would get lost and perish. Yes, just for you. Do you feel special? Okay, that's at that room again. I think that's everyone in the core. Unless there's some more back this way. Yeah, I missed a couple of these because I went down the elevator first time I did this. So I've heard the fun value actually works now without outside tinkering. So I might have to do a quick run through and like montage fun events happening if I catch them. It's taking a nap. That must be a night-night. We were hired by Metaton to destroy you, but since he never paid us, we all decided to quit. No hard feelings. Nah, just business. As a youth, I would sneak out to play by this creepy flaming pit. Since the core is always rearranging, it was like a game trying to find it. Now it is my special place. It is nice for cooking spores and things like that. Ah. That's adorable. I might not be able to get the Burger Pants dialogue I think I can get, though, because I never bothered with the little side quest where you talk to him and Braddy and Caddy back and forth. Sorry, we aren't allowing any more guests at this time, or ever again. Sorry, the resort's shutting down, but I think you'll find it still great to pass through. Blub blub. Now we can live life without reservations. So, if we're leaving, will my job... Ugh, and I just got a raise, well... Guess every apple has its core. Surface world. Really? Maybe I'll be able to go 2 feet without running into a puzzle. Oh, we're all free? Oh, I guess I can stop licking this ficus. But I don't want to look like I messed up, so I'll keep going. Social pressure, ladies and gentlemen. Social pressure. Why is this person trying to sell me something? This is a hamburger restaurant. I'm just trying to survive. Yes, I'm trying to do my best Red impression. Oh god. Crap, I don't have any money. Well, I suppose I can see what the dream and the bad memory are worth to Temmy. Okay, and come back. Are you guys on your way out? Guess I'll catch up with you later. I love how this dragon actually has his hand up to his ear. You know, like you see people do with their cell phones. It's a nice little detail. Good news! The elevator started working again. But now it's been so busy, we still haven't gotten the chance to ride it. As a slime, I'm overjoyed. Elevator is in use. Although, I'm actually curious about something. Dream heals 12 hit points, the goal of determination. Room service never came. Sigh. Locked from the inside. Room service never came. No response. Trying to finish up work. Silly goop, dude. They should have a washer when being the janitor. Wouldn't make more sense. So, we're, like, totally free now, huh? Yeah, like, totally free. Like, cool. Yeah, like, cool. Like, millennia of being in prison finally over? Yeah, that's, like, pretty chill, I guess. Oh, oops, really? Well, when we said, we were hyped for the destruction of humanity, we were just, like, joking, you know? Did we say that? Probably. It's, like, practically our catchphrase. Really? I thought our catchphrase was, Brady's the best, Caddy's the coolest. No. We've, like, literally never said that. Can it be, though? Can it be? Now that we're gonna be free, like, oh my god, we can finally fulfill our dream of having a pet cat? That's, like, your dream, Caddy. But, Brady, I don't want to have a dream without you in it. Aw, Caddy. And, in my dream, you clean up after the cat. Caddy. Do you like cats? Me? Yeah, I love cats. They're, like, so tasty. They're, like, so cute. Brady, no! I'm just kidding. Kind of. Anyway, when was the last time you even saw a cat around here? Oh, just the other day. There was this cute little white cat walking around. It was, like, so clueless looking. I pet it for, like, an hour. Caddy? Yeah, Brady? I think that was, like, a dog. Dogs are just really firm cats. Oh. I just had to get that line. That line amuses me too much. I'm so excited to sell ice cream on the surface. If all humans are like you, then I'll still be able to sell to monsters, I hope. Aw. Undyne told us that the Royal Guard's being disbanded, bro. Like, bummer. Guess we'll have to get used to love and peace and stuff, man. He seems happy. What? Do you want a rematch? Just love his expression. Okay, I'm gonna skip ahead a smidge here. We'll chat up the Hotland people as usual. Don't worry. But I want to get to Temmie. I want to try to get to Temmie, sell some things, and get back to Burger Pants in this episode if I can. Oh yeah. Care for a ride? Waterfall, please. Remember to take a break every so often. Oh, come on, I just booted the game up. Give me a break. Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. Man, by the end of this trip, Frisk's clothes must be absolutely disgusting. Absolutely disgusting. Whoa, Tim here, good news. Shoot, hang on. Whoa, Tim here, news. Very goods. My brain kind of, like, put the next sentence in the sentence I was doing. It corrected the grammar. Whoa, Tim here, news. Very goods. Yay, yay, Tims can go free. A pleasing development, no? Whoa, if Tims can go on surface, can see lots of cute human. Everyone's go free, but Tim. Tim not live. Tim watch egg. Tim will be happy family. It's hard-boiled. I still contend that we have no idea what the reproductive life cycle is of a Temmie. For all we know, they do come from hard-boiled eggs. Although I still love the starfish theory that I had where, you know, the face comes off enough and it becomes a new Temmie, and then the old Temmie grows a new face. Mushroom dance. Mushroom dance. Whatever could it mean? Boop. It symbolizes my unbridled happiness. The government told me they are willing to transplant me outside. Why didn't you smile at my dance? It almost feels a little rude. She's waiting for someone to let her out. Hoives! Hoi, welcome to Datem Shop. Okay, she won't say anything different. Alright. Well, bad memories are worth 300. The locket is worth 250. Worn daggers are worth 250. Last dreams are 250. Right on. Let's see if I can haggle. Can I? Ah, fuck it, I don't need that much. And I suppose I don't need any- yeah, I really don't need anything else, so there you go, Temmie. Boy! Alright, we should be able to get to Burger Pants in time. I mean, I could always just make a cut of the traveling montage. In fact, I'm gonna do that. Be right back. And we are back! Give me the steak. What? Why do you keep trying to talk to me? I'll get in trouble if I get chummy with the customers. Sorry. So, I wanted to be an actor. So we're free, huh? Metaton told us as much. Then he told me. Don't think that means you're getting to work early. Ah, my boss. I love that guy. And by that, I mean I hate him so, so much. Those girls? The ones who saw my pants fall down? Well, we're all gonna be free. So I'll never have to see them again, at least. Don't tell anyone this, little buddy. Because they'll make fun of me. But I feel like I played a hand in everyone getting free somehow. Even if it was just working this awful job, I think I did something. I don't know if it's true, but I'll believe it anyway. Little buddy, there's a brand new world out there waiting for us. I'm sure with my qualifications, it won't be long before I'm a famous movie star. Or maybe I'll just end up flipping burgers again. But it's as I say, nowhere to go but up, literally, in this case. Anytime, little buddy. My best attempt at a Ren Hoek, or Hoek, I think is how you say his last name. It's supposed to sound very phlegmy. Damn, can't do that questline. Oh well. Oh well, what can you do? I'm kind of like mentally shaving off like 2 minutes off my timer here because I accidentally forgot to stop it when I was doing the skip section just there. Oh well. I ordered another hot dog, but the hot dog guy never came back. Besides that, today was fine. Count your blessings, even if you don't get a second hot dog. Toasty bun. He's just so happy to have the hot dog in his volcano? His crater, I guess? Oh, hello. Human, you're leaving? I have something to say about you. Admittedly, I may have had limerent feelings for you before. However, upon examining my own actions, I now realize I did not love you. I was merely infatuated with the concept of love. The idea of romance, the concept of sharing affection with another. Through these desires, I built a false concept of you in my head. Such a relationship would not have ended well. In closing, I believe it is better that I choose to say nothing. You idiot. Who knows what lies in the future for the art club? Who knows? There's a bit of section over there. Come on. If I can shimmy my way over there. No? Damn. I can't wave dash over there? Nope. Oh well. Fuck that room. I know how to do it now, but yeah, it's still a pain in the dick. Anyway, I think I'll actually cut this episode. This is going to be a long recording anyway, so I might as well keep it evenly 20 minutes-ish. Although this one will be a little under, I guess, because of the cut. But anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Twitter, Tumblr, and the subscription are in the description as usual. I love this extended sequence of an ending in the pacifist ending. It really does feel like a really big reward. And hopefully we actually find some new stuff in it too, because of this patch that apparently added a few things. But anyway, thank you all so much for watching, and ciao for now.